five main conditions which should prevail before pregnancy can come about. So let's take the first one, the sperm. The condition of the man to the child is from the sperm. And we look at certain parameters in the sperms that should be normal before pregnancy can come about. So when the man ejaculates the sperms into the vagina, the normal sperms that are released is very, very important. The movement of the sperms, how they move, because I said that the sperms, once the man ejaculates or releases the sperms to the vagina, the sperms starts moving into the womb. And they don't stop there, they go into the tubes. So the movement of the sperm must be good before they can reach where the egg is. That's the thing. And then the shape. So the sperms have got a particular shape. Like, you know how a tadpole is like? Yes. They're supposed to look like that. But some of them have abnormal tails that prevent them from moving normally. They have a round head that prevents them from entering the egg effectively. So the sperms can have abnormalities that will not allow the pregnancy to come about. In fact, some men don't even have sperm at all. They can have sex and ejaculate, release this what we call semen, but there's no sperm, living sperms inside the semen. And I'll show you why. Because the sperm is produced in the testes, and during sexual intercourse, when the man is ejaculating, the sperms will not move up from the testes and mix with some fluid around the prostate gland and the seminal vesicle before it comes out. So if there's a blockage from where the sperms are transported to the penis, the man can ejaculate all right, but there's no sperm to fertilize the egg. The second, come to the woman. The woman, there are normal factors there. There's the uterus there, the womb, where the pregnancy comes to stay. There are a lot of conditions that can affect the womb that might make pregnancy difficult to come about. For instance, if you look at this picture, there are fibroids there. These fibroids can make the transport of the sperm to the tubes very difficult, make the journey longer, okay, and then make the pregnancy more difficult to come about. There are some, for instance, if the fibroid grows big, it can block the tube. So once the tube is blocked, the sperm cannot pass through the tube to meet the egg. And also, some women don't have uterus. They are born without a womb. So if she hasn't got a womb, how can she get pregnant?